Well, we are bringing a taste of Mexico to the kitchen this morning as Lily Ramirez Foran from Dublin's Picado Mexican Cookery School joins us.
Yes. So what is on the menu for us today?
So we're going to be doing some mushroom tacos, right? Mm. I think it's a great taco to have on your repertoire if you have vegan or vegetarian friends. Sorry, I'm just going to lower the heat here a tiny bit. What is it with induction hubs and me?
We get this every day, don't worry.
Yeah, exactly.
God so almighty. Is that just...
So, I have a little bit of onion and coriander...
jalapeno.
Oh my God, jalapeno and garlic here. And I'm just going to make it translucent. You have one I made earlier. And I love this taco because you can kind of... It's quite fresh and really tasty. Quite substantial as well. And you can kind of... kind of vary what type of mushrooms you have.
Well,
you
that's what I was going to say. It doesn't look like one mushroom there.
No, you want different, because every mushroom, believe it or not, has a different texture and a different flavour, right? And I see you don't
I'm
like mushrooms
really
and your eyeballs are hurting from rolling.
Well,
right?
I'm going to try it. It's
a
just
little
the
bit
texture.
Of, yeah.
Do you find that?
No, I like the texture. I know what you're saying about the texture can be a little slimy, sluggish, but...
Sorry, no, like, do you know, like, it's like, that's the, it's the sliminess of it.
But what if you
I'm
going to
try it, though. I'm happy to.
Thank you. So we're going to have it with a bit of feta cheese.
Yeah.
In Mexico, we would use queso fresco, but here we've no...
What's the difference?
Basically, it's very similar. It's salty, creamy, crumbly. Maybe Mexican queso fresco is slightly saltier.
Okay.
Which is nice. Now, you also have some poblano peppers in your... in your taco, so it's not just mushrooms. And poblano peppers, I was saying at the break, they're like the top model version of a bell pepper. They're tall and skinny, beautiful. And they're a little bit spicier than a bell pepper, but not much.
And then what is this accompaniment you've given us here in this little bowl?
And that's just a regular everyday salsa.
Okay.
So put in a little bit of salsa.
Is it like a mild one or?
It's mild, yeah.
Right, okay.
So I've added my mushrooms and I'm reducing them and my poblano peppers. I'm not awake today. What's wrong with me?
No, you and me both. Don't worry.
Oh, my God.
Lily.
And then I'm adding a Mexican kind of herb called epazote.
Yes, I was wondering that.
This is also known as Mexican tea. It's actually a native cooking herb from Mexico.
If I go home to my wife and bring another herb, do you know what I mean? Like,
it just stays in the cupboard.
It's been there for 10 years.
It's kind of quite aniseedy, and it's really, Mexicans use it a lot for cooking.
And it's called, what's it called?
Epazote.
Epazote.
You can buy it online at the shop with us, but what it does is actually helps break compounds in the mushrooms, and it is actually a really nice herb. Mexicans cook beans with it. You will never have beans that have not had some epazote, but because it kind of breaks the problem that you have with a lot of pulses and legumes that they develop a bit of wind. So epazote takes care of that. So once you add
your epazote... The taste is lovely. It's just the texture.
This might be actually better for
you, Tommy. It tastes delicious, and I love the feta with it, and you can feel a kick off the peppers.
The peppers. Mm. I'm going to add a little bit of, I love chefs, we call, a little bit of dollop of butter at the end, just to make everything creamier.
And that's it? So you're just frying it all down?
It's so simple. And you can have, like, you have your cheese and a really nice salsa. And if you have a problem with texture, I'm going to suggest, because you're having it on a soft corn tortilla that I'm actually going to heat up there, you can actually make a tostada, which is just a crispy corn tortilla.
Yeah.
And that kind of gives you extra texture
if
mushrooms are a problem for you. But I love these because you can vary every time you kind of go to the market and get a really fresh mushroom. We have shiitake here, we have button mushrooms, we have cremini. There's loads of different lovely mushrooms here. And it's a great taco to have for, like, a quick option for a vegetarian.
They share so
friend.
Much, though, mushrooms. So if you're feeding a family of four, say, how, like, is that going to be four packets of mushrooms then?
Well,
to keep them
usually
going?
I buy my mushrooms because there's a lot of wild mushrooms mixed. So I buy my mushrooms by weight. So I have about, this is half the recipe because I did half earlier and half. So, but like you need about 500 grams. And I would also advise to have like a little bit of beans and some other fresh stuff that you can add to your taco. So it builds up a lovely meal. Usually tacos, you have two or three fillings at the table. So these would be one of them.
If you have somebody who's vegetarian in the family, but then so you could cook that for them. But is there kind of, could you add meat to it if you were to have
that's the lad talking.
Yeah,
totally. You can.
So just like a shredded chicken or something into
have,
that.
You can actually. These would work really well with like a really good poached skirt.
Oh, yeah.
Really nice. Just poach it in a little bit of onion, garlic.
Like skirt steak?
Yeah.
Yeah, okay.
And then just cook it. And you can slice it if you want to grill it or you want to poach it. And then just add these as a topping if you want.
And then some refried beans and stuff on the side. Yeah. And
I don't eat avocados, but you can have guacamole
nachos.
If you want. Yeah.
And then, so then when you've had that done for about 8 to 10 minutes, would you say?
Yeah, I mean, we cooked it here live. It's fairly quick.
So 5 minutes then,
Now, I was scorching the pan because I'm always worried about timing.
Of course.
But then you just get your warm corn tortillas, and we always use corn in Mexico. You could, if you want, wheat tortillas. But you just gently heat your tortilla at high heat and then just build your taco. And this is another thing that's great about Mexican food. It's very convivial. You can have everything at the table. And if you have kids get really involved making tacos, and it's a great way for them to kind of eat.
And they can kind of control what they put in. Because, you know, instead of going, well, what's this? You know, if they feel they know exactly what they've put on their plate, they're more inclined to control.
Yes. I honestly think that's what it is. And just top it with you can make a fresh salsa, or you can top it with, this is one of my favorite shop bought salsas, but you can have a really nice healthy taco there very quickly, very little effort.
Excellent, Lily. Thank you very much.
Thanks,
Delicious. Very good.
Delicious. Now, as the country continues to slowly navigate through COVID-19 restrictions, today sees the reopening of outdoor visitor attractions such as the zoo and heritage sites. Our reporter Brianna is at Dublin Zoo to hear how they have prepared to reopen.
Look forward to that.